Before that film clip, Martin Luther was in law school, and he was coming home one weekend, and he was on a muddy road walking, and there was a horrible thunderstorm. Lightning and thunder was all around him, and Martin Luther was getting scareder and scareder for his life, and finally a crack hit right beside him, and it drove him to his knees. And Martin Luther cried out, "God, don't let me die like a dog on the road. Don't let me die. Don't let me die. I will give myself to you. Spare me. Help me. I will give myself to you. Just spare my life, Lord Jesus." And God spared his life. He wasn't killed in that. And he said, "I'd give my life to you." So what Martin Luther did was he became a monk. And so he put on his robe to become monks. So I do this so that you remember this is a pastor that puts on clothes. Don't take off clothes. As I'm known, oh, that's the pastor that took off his clothes. So we're trying to change that. I'm putting clothes on so you can remember that. Martin Luther became a monk. So before that, he was scared. He was scared of lightning and of dying. But then he became a monk and he battled with God because he still was frightened. He was frightened because of all his sin. He was frightened that he was too sinful to do anything. And he argued with God over his sin. And in fact, it came to the point that he was in his room one time arguing with God about, "Oh, I'm such a sinner. I can't become a priest because I'm so sinful." And the head of the order was walking outside and heard Martin Luther battling with God about being such a horrible sinner. And so the head of the order came in and he said, "Martin Luther, what's the problem?" And Martin Luther said, "I'm a horrible person. I'm a sinner." And apparently Martin Luther had been at the monastery for 2 years, and the head of the order said, "Martin, I have heard your confessions for 2 years. I have heard all sorts of sins that you have done. Not one is remotely outstanding." Saying to Martin Luther, "You're not that great of a sinner. You haven't really done anything too bad." But still, Martin Luther was terrified of God's judgment. He thought God was always angry with us, with him and with us, and that God threatened us with throwing us in the lake of fire for all eternity. Martin Luther realized that these were lies that Satan, the great accuser, was accusing him of. Satan accuses us at all times, trying to convince us that we're not good enough to be loved by God. Why would God love a person like me? I'm not good enough. I'm not good looking enough. I'm not good enough in athletes or in sports or in singing. I'm a sinner. I've done this. I've done that. Satan is great at accusing us. It was like a book I read many years. I think it was entitled Turkey and Eagles. Anyhow, it was about an eagle that was brought up by turkeys. So this eagle in all its majestic would just stay with the eagles, pecking at the ground, looking down all the time. Once in a while it would look up and it would see the eagle soaring and it'd say, "Oh, if only I could be an eagle, but I'm a lowly turkey." Satan tells us that we are turkeys and that we're not good enough to be eagles. But that's not the truth. We are God's sons and daughters. We are eagles that can soar. During this time, Martin Luther had posted the 95 Theses. He had been hidden, whisked away, because the authorities, the Roman Catholic Church, wanted to kill him for his beliefs and his teaching. And when he was in this tower, being protected, he meditated on a lot of verses, and one of those was Romans 1:7. And Romans 1:7 says, "The person in right standing before God trusts in him." And up to that point, Martin Luther had always thought, and the Roman Catholic Church had said, had taught, that a person in right standing, that you had to be righteous on your own. You couldn't sin. If you sin, you had to do penance, you had to pay money. It was all about you getting right, and then you could trust in God. But Martin Luther saw that in a new light. The person in right standing before God, comma, trusts in him. If you trust in God, you're in right standing with God. It's nothing that you do. It's what God has done. Martin Luther finally understood that God was a merciful God. God was a loving God. All we need to do is look towards God, and God does the rest. That's what makes us righteous. It's not about us. Christ saves us. Then that brings us to the part in the film clip you saw of Martin Luther preaching. And what Martin Luther says is, when what he said to the congregation, when Satan accuses you and tells you you're not good enough to be loved by God, that you deserve death and to go to the lake of fire, admit it. Admit it to Satan. Says, yeah, say, yeah, I'm not good enough, but I have somebody that died on my behalf, somebody that sacrificed for me, the Lord Jesus Christ. And where he is, I will be also. So it doesn't matter what we have done in life or what we will do or what the inside of us, whether it's sinful or not, it's about Jesus Christ. And by looking to him, by believing in him, where he is, we will be also. So wherever we're at, Jesus is with us, and we will live with him in eternity. And that was Martin Luther's testimony to the risen Lord Jesus Christ. He finally understood it, that it was about what Jesus did on the cross by dying for our sins and rising for eternal life, that it was what Jesus did, not what we do. That was Martin Luther's testimony to the risen Lord Jesus. Jesus died and was resurrected for you, the good news. Satan holds no power over you. Christ has set you free. What is your testimony to the risen Lord? In Acts today, in our scripture reading, we read the apostles with great power gave their testimony to the resurrection of the Lord Jesus. The apostles with great power gave their testimony. The disciples had seen Jesus died and buried and resurrected alive. They could not believe that Black Friday, when their teacher was killed, became Good Friday. Why did it become Good Friday? Because of Easter, the resurrection. That was their testimony. That's a testimony that Jesus died for our sins, was buried, crucified, and died, but resurrected. That was their testimony. That is a testimony. My own testimony about the risen Lord came, I know, when it struck home for me about Jesus rising from the dead. What was my testimony? It was in 2004, and I was at giving a message in the Church of Nazarene, a Church of Nazarene church, and I had a cup similar to this cup. And I was talking about how the blood of Jesus Christ washes us clean, no matter how dirty we are. And I said the Pharisees and Sadducees, they worried about the outside of the cup, but God's worried about the inside of the cup, and that's what his blood cleanses us. A normal sermon. However, I had taken the cup and got it really mud inside and out, muddy inside and out, with some really good mud, apparently. Because I could wipe the outside off, and I said, the outside's clean, Jesus washes us, but he also was worried about our inside. And then I started to scrub the inside, and I could not get that clean. So I'm trying to think fast on my feet, and I say to myself, okay, I just won't show him the inside of the cup. I'll just tell him, Jesus cleans us inside and out. I won't show him the inside. And then that's when I had my testimony of the risen Christ. I said to myself, no, that's not Jesus Christ. It doesn't matter how dirty we are. It doesn't matter what sin we have committed in our lives. It doesn't matter about us. It's about Jesus Christ's power, about his blood that cleans us. So I put my hand in my little cloth I had. I scrubbed that much harder because I said, God always gets us clean. And I got it clean and I showed them. That was my testimony to the risen Lord. I finally understood that it was about Jesus, not about us. And no matter how bad we are or how bad we think we are or how much Satan accuses us, it's Jesus Christ that makes us as white as snow. Jesus said this about his crucifixion and resurrection. This is my blood of the new covenant, which is shed for the forgiveness of sins. All who believes in me shall never die. All who believes in me shall never die. What is your testimony of the risen Lord? Today, we're part of that testimony is believing and taking communion, because it's God's blood shed for you for the forgiveness of sin. All who turn to Jesus, all who believes in Jesus, he does it all. He forgives your sin. He makes you white as snow. And where he is, you will be also. When you die, you go to heaven. You will be where Jesus is. The three scriptures for today, we read only one. There is one from 1 John and 1 John, the gospel. I want to read them, just a verse or two from them. Acts 4 is the one that we talked about, 33. With great power, the apostles gave their testimony to the resurrection of the Lord Jesus, and great grace was upon them all. And then from 1 John, we declare to you what was from the beginning, what we have heard and what we have seen with our eyes and what we have looked at and touched with our hands concerning the word of light. The apostles were witnesses to Jesus Christ, and they gave their testimony that he rose from the dead for everlasting life for all of us. We declare to you what we have seen and heard so that you also may have fellowship with us. And truly our fellowship is with the Father and with his Son, Jesus Christ. So you may have fellowship with us. We have a testimony of the risen Lord Jesus so that we can give that testimony to others so they also can follow Jesus Christ. And then from John chapter 20, verses 30 through 31. Now Jesus did many other signs in the presence of his disciples, which are not written in this book, but these are written so that you may come to believe that Jesus is the Messiah, the Son of God, and through believing you may have life in his name. What is your testimony to the risen Lord? What is your testimony to the risen Lord?